I'm going to show three different techniques that help you free up space on your Mac's hard drive. We'll go over everything from removing hidden files, clearing out system data, uninstalling unnecessary applications, and I'll show you how to scan your computer to see what's taking up space, as well as how to easily filter and show only the big files on your system. We'll make this easy, and you don't need to be an expert by any means to do this. All you need is to have a way to find and filter the files that are taking up the most space, and I'll show you how to do that. We'll start from the easiest ways to free up space and move on to more advanced techniques after that. First, I'll give you a quick rundown on the storage analyzer that's built into your system settings and how to use that to free up space. Then, we'll take a look at how you can search based on file size, which is a great way to quickly locate large files and delete them. And lastly, I'll show you how to reveal hidden files on your computer, which is a great way to clear up system data or files you can't otherwise locate on your computer. This is also a very effective way to free up space, and I know people who have cleared hundreds of gigabytes by following these steps. And before we get this party started, a couple of reminders. Deleting files is permanent, so make sure all your important files are backed up and take a second to double-check everything before you delete files. Once we start looking at hidden system files, it's crucial that you only delete files you are sure can be deleted. We're going to reveal some important system files that are hidden for a reason, and deleting the wrong files can cause issues with your computer, so never delete anything if you're not 100% sure it can be deleted. All right, let's start by going to System Settings, General, and Storage. This is a good way to get an overview of what's taking up space on your computer. You'll get a visual graph up top showing you what's taking up space, and below that, you'll have some recommendations. This menu can look different depending on what version of macOS you're using. I'll give you a quick walkthrough, and later in this video, we'll move on to a more thorough way to clear up space, which will apply to any version of macOS. Storing in iCloud is the first recommendation, but I avoid that because my iCloud account has way less space than my hard drive, and the more space you use in iCloud, the more you'll have to pay for it. Below that, you might see an option to optimize your Apple TV storage. This will remove movies and TV shows from your computer, and even though it usually doesn't make a huge difference, it's an easy way to save some space. You'll also have an option to set up your trash to empty automatically. I manually empty mine pretty frequently, so I don't use it, but some people might find this convenient. And remember, when you delete files, the disk space won't become free until you've emptied your trash. So make sure to empty your trash every now and then. Under that, you'll get a list of items that are taking up the most space. Click the Info button, and you'll get a list where you can individually delete documents or applications. When it comes to applications, you can usually delete them directly from here, but some applications come with an uninstaller that does a more thorough job of removing all the different components of that application. For example, any Adobe application will have an uninstaller next to the application. And if you want to make sure that all the files related to that application are getting deleted, it's always better to use the uninstaller. But for applications like these that don't have an uninstaller, you can simply delete them here or through the System Settings view we were looking at. Looking at documents, you'll get a similar view sorted by the file size. You can delete files straight from here, and if you want to double check something, hit the spacebar and the quick look window will open, allowing you to preview the file. Up top, you'll have a few tabs giving you different views. You can look at large files only, your download folder, unsupported applications, or browse through your system using the file browser, which conveniently shows the size of each folder and file. So overall, this is an easy way to free up some space, but there are some files you won't see here. Before we move on to my favorite way to clear up space, let's talk about these three items on the bottom. Other users and shared means the amount of data that's taken up by other user accounts on your computer. Everything you see in this video will only show files that belong to the user account you're currently logged into. So if you have multiple user accounts on your computer, you'll have to log into each account separately and repeat the steps. macOS indicates how much space is used by your operating system. This is the system that keeps your computer running, so there's nothing you can do to reduce this. And lastly, system data. These are system files that your computer is storing in order to work faster, and it's all hidden from the user. The problem is, system data tends to grow to unreasonably large amounts, and Apple doesn't give you an easy way to clear it. But I'll show you how to get rid of that in just a minute. Just a quick side note, even though system data can contain a lot of useless files that are easy to delete, some of this data is always needed by your system to function. So in other words, you'll never get it down to zero. But I'll show you how to minimize it as much as possible. Let's look at a more manual way to clear up space next. I know my computer and folders pretty well, so what I like to do is to go through all my folders one by one and just get a quick overall check on the folders and files that take up the most space and delete what I don't need. A good way to navigate through the folders on your Mac is to use the sidebar in Finder. By default, some of these folders might be hidden for you, so you can always go to your Finder settings and enable the ones you'd like to have visible in your sidebar. I like to go through the folder one by one, put them in a list view, and check the sizes for everything. The best way to check the size is to hit Command plus J, and check the box that says Calculate All Sizes. This forces Finder to calculate the size for each folder, giving you an easy way to sort based on the biggest folders. Now you can simply go through all the different areas of your computer, sort by the biggest files, and see what you want to delete to free up space. As you navigate through different folders, you might need to hit Command plus J again and check the box Calculate All Sizes again. This might be a bit of a tedious way of cleaning up your Mac, but I like it because it allows me to get a good idea on where all that disk space is going, and it gives you something to be aware of moving forward in case the same folders keep filling up time after time. If you just want a quick way to get rid of some of the larger files on your Mac, you can do this instead. Type anything in the search bar so you can access the filtering options for your search. Spotlight Search has the ability to search files based on their file size, which is a great way to reveal all the biggest storage consumers if you don't feel like flipping through your folders one by one. If you don't have file size as a filtering option in the list, you can simply add it to the list like I'm doing here. After that, just refine your search to find files based on a specific file size. I'm going to look for files that are 10 gigabytes or larger. And now that we've refined the search, I can just erase the search term I used in the beginning to make sure Spotlight will reveal everything on my system that's over 10 gigabytes. So what about that darn system data I mentioned earlier? Here's a good way to reveal all the hidden files on your Mac and get rid of system data and everything else you don't want. First, we'll go to our home folder. This is the root of your user account, and you'll see all those folders we were previously looking at in our sidebar. Now this is where we'll turn it up a notch and start looking at our hidden files. On your keyboard, use the combination of Shift, Command, and the period key, and boom. Finder will show you all the hidden files on your system. Then, I'm using the same Command plus J, command to calculate all sizes, and I'll be able to sort by the folders that take up the most space, including all the hidden files and folders. You'll see how the hidden library folder takes up a ton of space here. That's 560 gigabytes we had no clue about prior to this. I said this earlier and I'll say it again. When dealing with hidden files, it's important that you don't delete anything you're not sure about. There's going to be a lot of temporary cache files that you can delete without any issues, but you'll also see a lot of important system files that should never be deleted. So keep that in mind. I have a separate tutorial on how to properly navigate this view here and what things to look out for, so I'll link it in the description below. But in my case right here, looks like most space is taken up by Dropbox. For that, I would just go to my Dropbox folder and unsync anything that I don't want on my computer. If you're using Adobe applications, those are notorious for filling up your library folder with cache files. Cache files are temporary files that get regenerated all the time, so those are usually safe to delete, and I've often seen system data on my Mac get wiped out in real time when clearing up stuff here. So those are my favorite ways to clear up space on a Mac. It's really not complicated. You just need to know a good way to navigate through your folder structures and be able to inspect the file size for everything on your computer, and these steps will 100% help you do that. If you have any questions or any issues, drop me a comment below and I'll be happy to help you out. And needless to say, there's always going to be a point where your hard drive simply isn't large enough to hold all the important files, so it's also smart to invest in a good external hard drive. I'll link my favorite in the description.